Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. In this video, I'm explaining about miscellaneous exercise on Chapter 9, Sequences and Series, question number 29 and 30 solution. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. Question number 29. A person writes a letter to four of his friends. He asks each one of them to copy the letter and mail to four different persons with the instruction that they move the chain similarly. Assuming that the chain is not broken and that it costs 50 paisa to mail one letter, find the amount spent on the postage when each set of letter is mailed. See, in this question, they have given that a person writes a letter to four of his friends. That means in the first set, there are four letters. The person is writing a letter to four of his friends. So there are four letters. So there is one person and that one person writes a letter to four of his friends. That means four letters. Next, again, then what will happen? He asks each one of them to copy the letter and mail to four different persons. Again, that person tells his friends to send the same letters to four of his friends. That means these four friends now again send that particular letter to four of his friends. That means 4 into 4. That is, suppose if you consider that this person send letter to his four of his friends, then these four people again send the letter to his four of friends. That means here this particular person send 4 letters. Again, this particular person sent 4 letters and this will send 4 letters and this will send 4 letters. Again, here that person will send letter, that is 4 letters to 4 of his friends. Again, this person will send 4 letters to 4 of his friends. So like this, with the chain is continuing. So you can see that here we have first of all one person, that one person is sending a letter to 4 of his friends. That means there are 4 letters. Next, again, those 4 friends are sending again letters to 4 of their friends. That means 4 into 4, that is 16. Next, again, these 16 friends again sending letters to their friends. That is 4 letters they are sending. One person is sending 4 letters. So 16 into 4, 64. Then again, 64 friends we have. In that one person, each person is sending 4 letters. That means 64 into 4, that is 256. So this is the first set, second set, third set, fourth set. So like this way, here we need to find out the 8th set letter. That is the total amount spent to post the 8th set letter. So that we need to find out here. See, now here, if you consider these terms, then this particular term forms a GP. See, here we have 4, 16 in the second set. In the third set, we have 64. In the fourth set, we have 256. So like this way, we have to find out the 8th set. And this value forms a geometric progression. Here, A is equal to 4. And the common ratio, that is 16 divided by 4 is 4. Or 64 divided by 16 is 4. So this value is in the form of geometric progression. In the geometric progression, to find the sum, we have the formula Sn is equal to A into r to the power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1 if r greater than 1. And Sn is equal to A into 1 minus r to the power n divided by 1 minus r if r is less than 1. Now in this case, r value is 4. That means r value is greater than 1. So we are going to use this formula. In this formula, substitute the value. See here, A is equal to 4, r is equal to 4, that is 16 divided by 4. And here we need the amount spent for the 8th set. That means n is equal to 8. That is 8th term we need here. So n is equal to 8. Now substitute the value. S8 is equal to 4 into r to the power n. That is 4 to the power 8 minus 1 divided by 4 minus 1. That is equal to 4 divided by 3 into 4 to the power 8 minus 1. That is equal to 4 divided by 3 into 4 to the power 8 is 65536 minus 1. That is 4 divided by 3 into 65535. That is equal to, here you can cancel this value with the 3. That is 3 ones are, then 3 twos are 6. Then we have here 3 ones are 3. Remaining value, again we have here after like multiplying this one, after dividing this value with this here, we get the final answer as 21845. Then multiply this with this, so we get here 87380. So now here we got that 87380, that is the total number of letters. But in the question, they have given that the cost for one letter is 0.50 paisa. This is nothing but, we can write this one as 0.5 is nothing but half. So that I am taking as half. Now we need to calculate the total cost to send these letters. So total cost is equal to, for one letter the cost is 0.5 paisa. So how many cost how much it will cost for these letters, that we have to calculate. That is 87380 into half. Half is nothing but 0.5. That is equal to 43,690. Question number 30. A man deposits rupees 10,000 in a bank at the rate of 5% simple interest annually. Find the amount in 15th year since they deposited the amount and calculate the total amount after 20 years. So here, see, they have given some values. The given values are, first they have given that the deposited amount is 10,000 and the rate of interest for this deposit amount is 5%. This is given in the question. Next year, we need to find out the amount in the 15th year and then amount after 20 years. So these two values we need to find out. One is amount in 15th year, another one is amount after 20th year. So now here, see, first of all here, to find out this one, we will find out here the terms. So to find out the terms here, we will first find out the interest after first year, second year, third year, like that way. So interest after first year is, see here, we have the amount 10,000, so 5% will be given interest. So 10,000 into 5 divided by 100, that is 500. So after 1 year, 500 interest will be given, and we have, that is the person has deposited 10,000. So the total amount is 10,000 plus 500, that is 10,500. Next, again, after second year, see, after second year, again the interest will be given for that second year, plus already we have this one. So 10,500 plus 500, that is 11,000. Then after third year, again for the third year, 500 interest will be given. So 11,000 plus 500, that is 11,500. So now we can take the terms like this way, 10,000, 10,500, 11,000, 11,500, like this way. And this value, see here, if you observe these values, this value forms the arithmetic progression. Here we have the first term as 10,000, and if you find the common difference, that is 10,500 minus 10,000, we get the same value here for two continuous terms, that is 500. So now here, as this value forms a arithmetic progression, here by using the arithmetic progression concept, we can find out the amount in 15th year and amount after 20th year. See here, there is a major difference, that is amount in 15th year and amount after 20th year. See, amount in 15th year means we have to consider all the interest starting from, that is the from the beginning, that is from the beginning year 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 14. 15th year is not included. 15th year interest is not included, that is up to 14th year, because here it is given that amount in the 15th year. Next, again here we have amount after 20 year. Amount after 20 year means you have to start from the beginning 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 20th you have to take. That means up to 20 year. Amount you have to calculate. 20 year is also included, because in the question they have given that after 20 year, whereas here they have given that in 15th year. So this is the major difference between these two values. So just note down that. Now here let us calculate that. See here, first we have to calculate the amount in 15th year. So amount in 15th year means here we have to find out the term, that is the 15th term we need to find out. The 15th term, generally in the case of arithmetic progression, to find the nth term we have the formula an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Now here we need to find out the 15th term, and see here one more thing, whenever we are considering the terms here, I have taken like this way. See, this is the first year. After first year, the amount will amount must be this much. After second year, the amount must be this much. But here, if you consider the terms, this is the first term, this is the second term, and this is the third term. See here, we have after first year, the amount is this much, and this is the second term. This is the second year amount, and this is the third term. This is the third year amount, so this is the fourth term. You can observe that. See, in the question, they have asked us to find out the amount in 15th year. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 14th we have to consider. So here, if you observe these values, see, always the term value is 1 more than this one, right? Here we have 3rd year, the term is 4. Here we have 2nd year, the term is 3. So now here, we need up to 14th, right? 14th term. I mean 14th year, the values. So 14th year means here, this particular term is nothing but A15, right? See here, 3rd year means the term is A4. 2nd year means the term is A3. So in the same way, 14th year means the term is A15. So here we need to find out now A15. So A15 is equal to, here put the value, A is 10,000 plus N value, that is 15 minus 1 into D is 500. So now here we have 10,000 plus 14 into 500, that is equal to 10,000 plus 700, that is 17,000. So the amount in 15th year is 17,000. Next, again we need to calculate here amount after 20 year. See, after 20 year means, that is from the beginning up to 20 year we have to consider. So 20 year means the term is 21st term, right, isn't it? If you observe this one, 2nd year means 3rd term, 1st year means 2nd term, 3rd year means 4th term, this is. So 20 year, that is 20 year means 21st term. So here we need to find out A21. See, this is the difference between amount in 15th year and amount after 20th year. Amount in 15th year means 0 to 14. And here amount after 20th year means 0 to 20. So that is the reason that here I have written A21. Why this is A21? If you observe this one, you will understand that clearly. A21 is equal to, that is first term, that is 10,000 plus N is 21 minus 1, then into D. D is 500. So 10,000 plus 20 into 500, that is 10,000 plus 10,000, that is equal to 20,000. So this is the final answer. Thanks for watching.